Oh, platinum nga. Oh, platinum is not a gold.
It's color white, but parang white silver. You, white gold.
Yeah.
White gold. It's same gold, but it's like just like baka, platinum white siya.
Baka it's white gold.
Oh, ganun. White gold.
Remember, Bella has a beautiful hair, right?
Yes.
And like, So, okay, good.
We need to make sure
that look in this space. And what is the main concern of Della when he saw her husband's face? What did he fear?
I think Della was nervous that Jingle would get angry with her hair.
With her hair cut off?
Yeah.
Who else? Good. Who else has their own opinion about it?
Maybe
Cor? What? Cor, are you with us? Don't go to the light, okay?
Yes.
Who else? Who have... Okay. Marisa? No.
Because they considered her hair as one of their valuable possessions.
And I don't know what's going to happen. She's literally going to have her hair. She's a literal type like that. So what was Jin's gift? Ready?
A set of
what's so special about the phone?
That was Della likes.
Yeah, for a long time.
She went in a shop. Window shop.
Okay, so what did Jim use to get the
phone? This
watch. So this watch.
Yes.
Ironic. Right?
Yeah.
So if I was Della, did something that I sacrificed my own hair to give my husband a gold chain for his watch, and then my husband, who is also an Indian like me, sold his gold watch without any idea that me, the wife, would want to give a gold chain for that. So, with the twist of the story, do you think it is justifiable that the Hindi was called the master of surprise?
Yeah. Ironically speaking,
what made the story more surprising, Greggy?
It's ironic, and you see the twist that it's ironic because the post of the story is that the usual scenario, the usual thing that happens to a husband and wife, because especially. The way they express their love from one another is, you can see the degree of it. It really goes to show that it's their love to one another is so special that even their most priceless possession, they're willing to sacrifice it just to show their loved ones how much they appreciate and they value each other.
Yeah. 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 This is so prolific. Oh my God. Girls, you should find a husband like that, okay? In the next 15 years, you're only 16. 31 na kayo pag-asama. And what else? Who else can give me any opinion about the story? Or anything? Right? No wrong answers here. I'm encouraging you to talk. Give your opinion. LA.
Wait,
just
repeat your question.
Yeah. What made the story...
Watch. But then when Jim arrived home, he doesn't have the pocket watch anymore because he sold it. So he can buy the gift for him. So that's the case. So
Do you think it was a happy ending?
Yes.
Because they sacrificed
their vulnerable for the soul.
Would you do that, for example, to your parents, sacrifice something?
They weren't selfish for the vulnerable things they have.
That's inside.
Is there something that you're willing to sacrifice for your parents, like for Christmas? This whole story is not just about Christmas itself. It's about
giving.
Every day, you're willing to sacrifice for the people that you love. And Marla, since you're late, were you able to share the story?
Yeah.
What is your opinion about it?
It's very, you know, it's very touching at the same time.
But
three
are
wise
men. Okay, a little something about biblical history here so that you could understand also. They were called the wise men because during those times, people tend to look at the stars and the moon and the Venusian cycle to learn about when to harvest, when to declare war or something. So at that time, when Jesus Christ was born, figuratively and literally, was the guiding star, the Star of David. So the wise men brought gifts to you. You all know about it, the incense and the mirror and the practices in the boat. So there, Elmer, why do you think O. Henry used the title gift?